but you have made it a den of
a gathering storm. Such a strange day to reflect on, joy and anger and fear all muddled. Our little band of friends now huddled together in this tiny room within the white walls of our beloved city of Jerusalem, here by the Damascus Gate. We were early morning travellers from Bethany, coming for the ritual of the Passover. I'm lucky, a poor widow, but with good companions for the journey. Joy in our hearts as we contemplate the days of worship ahead. Our remembrances of the flight from Egypt by our ancestors. The angel of the true God passing over our homes. And the lintels being marked with blood of the sacrificial lamb, saving us from the fate of the doomed. The past year of baking and sewing, cleaning, scrimping the mites of money, I bought a small dove as my sacrifice offering. Not pure enough for our temple. A twisted claw. The black and white berobed priest haughtily waved me away. You must purchase here, only here. Friends took pity, rummaged their purses for coppers. I too paid the exorbitant price. Joy turning to resentment, frustration and anger. But suddenly there's a great commotion amongst the stallholders. A man is running amok, untying the sacrificial lambs, opening the cages of the doves, even upturning the tables where the greedy moneylenders exchange currencies at vast profit. He is shouting something about his father's house, about a lack of respect, a desecration. Another madman, perhaps? But he has followers with him, dressed as from the country regions of Nazareth. We often joke about nothing good coming out of that town. There's pandemonium. The priests and Pharisees are in turmoil. Nothing like this has ever happened before. Jesus, Jesus, one of his friends calls to him. They must be fearful that the hullabaloo will get him arrested. Come away, before the Roman guards are called. We talk, and one of our companions recalls the name, Jesus of Nazareth. Some say a prophet, a miracle worker, friend to our neighbours Martha, Mary and Lazarus, a raiser of the dead. And heretic to some. We are a subjugated nation. Oppression from Rome, suppression by the Sanhedrin, Herod's temple still unfinished, our inconsequential puppet king. Woe is everywhere. Something needs to change. Perhaps today we are witness to that. But this man's actions will not go unpunished. That I am sure of.
I but call your name, will you go where you don't know and never be the same? Will you let my love be shown? Will you let my name be known? Will you let my life be grown in you and you in me?
In your company.